Hello and welcome to the Kikusui Electronics Corporation YouTube channel. Today I'm here with the PWR-01, the newest addition to our benchtop DC power supply lineup, and I'll be showing you the basic navigation of the new interface and how to use some of its features. Features can be accessed by pressing the config button, and you can cycle through the preset configurations by repeatedly pressing this button. One is for basic features, two is for alarm settings, 3 is for usability settings such as brightness and alarm noise. 4 is for system settings such as interface configuration as well as master-slave operation. 50 through 68 are for LAN settings such as IP addresses and domain numbers. 70 and 71 are for USB connection. 72 for RS-232C connection. And the last configurations, 80 through 84, are for your sequence creation. As you can see, there are many configurations and features available with the PWR-01, but it is very user-friendly and easy to use. While scrolling through these configurations, if you're not sure what the configuration number stands for, you can press the Shift button or Local button located under the current knob, and it will provide a quick explanation. The first configuration that we encounter is the reset setting, where we can reset the panel settings at any time by pressing the blinking set button twice. Next, we have config 1, which is the bleeder setting. The PWR-01 internal bleeder circuit controls the sink of output current and can be used to prevent battery condensers from charging. The PWR-01 internal bleeder circuit controls the sink of output current and can be used to prevent battery or condensers from discharging. The PWR-01 has the ability to turn off the bleeder circuit or even turn on the hyper bleeder function, which is a little bit noisy, but allows for a 70% faster fall time. Now, let's skip over to config 3, where we can control the internal resistance of the PWR-01. This is extremely useful for simulating resistance found in deteriorating batteries, ideal for the automotive, solar panel, and fuel cell industries. The amount of resistance you can apply internally depends on the model, and with this specific model, the PWR-801ML, the maximum amount of resistance is 2 ohms. Next, we have our soft start and soft stop settings. This allows us to control the speed of our power supply's rise time from 0.05 to 10 seconds, which limits inrush current and is much gentler on the product that we are testing. Let's skip over to CF06 and CF07 to access the soft start stop time in CV mode, setting the start time to 3 seconds and the stop time to 3 seconds as well. As you can see, when I press the output button, the LED light is slowly fed current with little to no inrush current that could possibly damage the device. Lastly, we have the on-off delay found in CF08 and CF09, which allows you to control the amount of time output is turned on and off after you physically press the output button for up to 99 seconds. This is perfect for applications such as microcontroller testing, where the precise time and order of rise and drop voltage is essential. Let's set the on delay to 4 seconds and the off delay to 3 seconds. So when I press output on, it takes a full 4 seconds until it is actually output off. And when I press output off, three seconds until output is actually turned off. All right, so that is all for my quick Alright, so that is all for my quick explanation of a few of the PWR-01's basic features. For more information, please visit us at kikusui.co.jp or feel free to contact us via email, Facebook, LinkedIn, or in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching.